Events are specialized delegates that are useful for when you want to alert other classes that something has happened. In practice, you will see that events function very similarly to public multicast delegates. For more information on delegates, see the lesson on delegates linked below. An event can be thought of like a broadcast system. Any class that is interested in an event can subscribe methods to it. When that specific situation occurs, like a button click, a power-up, or player injury, we invoke our event, and that in turn calls the methods of the subscribed classes. We have here a scene with two orbs in it. One orb has a script called teleport script, while the other has a script called turn color script. Attached to our camera is an event manager script. An event can be made for just about any situation, but in this example, we want to invoke an event whenever the player clicks a button that we are drawing to the screen. In our event manager, we can see that we first create a delegate type, which we name ClickAction. We can see that any method that wishes to subscribe to our event must take no parameters and have a return type of void. Next, we create our event variable. We do this with the event keyword. Note that this variable is also static, so that we can use it outside of the class without instantiating an object of this class. Our event variable, which we have named onClicked, is of the type of the delegate we created above. The only other thing this class is responsible for is calling the event whenever the appropriate situation arises. Like we stated before, we will call this event whenever the player clicks our button. Therefore, this script has an onGUI method. Inside the onGUI method, we create a button on our screen. When the player clicks the button, we use our event variable as if it was a function. This, in effect, invokes our event. Please note that just like delegates, it causes an error if we invoke an event with no subscribers. Therefore, we should always make sure that the event does not equal null before invoking it. If you recall, the two orbs in our scene have two different scripts attached to them. These two scripts will act as subscribers to this event. Let's take a look at them now. In the teleport script, we have created a method called teleport. This is the method that we will be subscribing to the event that we created in the event manager. You will notice that the teleport method takes no parameters and has a return type of void, just like our delegate. The teleport method is responsible for positioning the object randomly along the y-axis. Near the top of our script, we have a method named onEnable. This is a built-in method that will be called whenever the object that the script is attached to is created or enabled in a scene. We will use this method to subscribe our teleport method to the onClicked event of the event script. We can see that we subscribe a method to an event by using the plus equals operator. By subscribing a method to an event, we ensure that whenever the event occurs, our method will be called. Next, we have the onDisable method. Opposite of the onEnable method, the onDisable method is called whenever an object is disabled or destroyed in a scene. Inside the onDisable method, we are unsubscribing our method from the event. We unsubscribe a method from an event using the minus equals operator. Doing so will ensure that our method is no longer called when an event occurs. This step is incredibly important, and failure to do so can lead to memory leaks and errors in your game. A good rule is that whenever you subscribe a method to an event, you must also have a corresponding unsubscribe. Our turnColor script is structured very similarly to our teleport script. In this case, we have a method called turnColor, which takes no parameters and has a return type of void. The turnColor method turns the object's material a random color. Again, we have the onEnable and onDisable methods. This time, they are subscribing and unsubscribing our turnColor method from the event. It is worth noting another time that unsubscribing our method from the event is paramount to using events correctly and preventing errors in our code. Back in Unity, we can run our scene. The first thing to notice is the button that appears near the top. Clicking this button will invoke our event and call the teleport and turn color methods. We can click the button multiple times, and each time, the subscribed methods will be called. As we can see, our event manager only needed to worry about the event itself and the triggers for the event. It did not need to know about the teleport script or the turn color script. Likewise, the teleport script and turn color script didn't need to know about each other. In this way, we are able to create a very robust and flexible broadcast system. You might be wondering why we used a static event variable instead of a public delegate variable in our event manager. The truth is, you can achieve the exact same functionality of events with public delegate variables. In fact, as we stated at the beginning of this lesson, events are just specialized delegates. The reason we use events over public delegate variables for situations like this is that events have inherent security where delegate variables do not. With events, other classes can only subscribe and unsubscribe. If we were to use a public delegate variable instead, other classes could invoke or override our delegate variable to do all sorts of nefarious things. Generally speaking, if you want to create a dynamic method system that involves more than one class, use event variables instead of delegate variables.